Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father Wheeland and I welcome you, all of you, in your wonderful numbers here today, as we come to commend this wonderful lady to an all-loving God. We thank God for the gift of Bernie, and let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and happiness of your saints, give to your servant Bernadette, for whom we offered the fraternal offices of burial, give her a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness that you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of this mortal life, she may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated for the Liturgy of the Word.
The first reading from the Old Testament will be done by Bernie's granddaughter, Cynthia.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all the peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm response will be led by Bernie's sister-in-law, Mary.
The responsorial psalm is, "The Lord is my light and my salvation."
The Lord is my
light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life and refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze at the lovingness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be short, stout-hearted, and wait for the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The second reading for the New Testament will be done by Bernie's granddaughter, Cassandra.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. Brothers and sisters, I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time has come for my departure. I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God already. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. So on behalf of Father Wheeland and myself and Ann Johnson and Tom Tammany and all of our people helping today with the liturgical ministry here, and in behalf of our resurrection choir, I want to offer to Bernie's immediate and extended families our sincere words of love and sympathy today. Almost in the same breath in which we offer that love and sympathy, before we forget the gospel reading, I'd like to make a little reference to the fact of kind of tying Bernie in with St. Thomas the Apostle. Not that she doubted like he did, and also not that his doubting was a horrible thing, because we all doubt at times. There's a great poet, Robert Browning, who says that we should prize the doubt and know that a doubt about sacred matters can be the raw material for a little tug of war that we have, maybe with ourselves, maybe with the world, the flesh, the devil, whatever. But a doubt can spark something within us, and we can go from the state of doubting to a wonderful belief. It's very possible that Thomas's faith was stronger than any of the others. We simply don't know. Another thing that I'd like to kind of separate us from is, you know, we hear so much about St. Paul and how terrible he was, and other people who were kind of notorious sinners. Being a notorious sinner first is not necessarily the best way to God. Being a notorious sinner provides God with an opportunity to just lavish us with his mercy. But even though we are all sinners in a big general way, the majority of people are awesomely good. So we're not trying to make a case for the fact that you have to have a dramatic journey through all kinds of terrible things, especially sin, and then finally stop sinning and then going to God. If we drew that out too far, we'd have people saying, well, I might just as well do what I want for quite a few years, and at the end I'll convert and come back to the church. No, it's not. Doesn't work like that. God welcomes all sinners, but remember, he welcomes children, and he welcomes those with the faith of children and her. And I just would like to share a little bit of what the family has given to me about her, how she was born up in the Adirondack area, Saranac Lake area, and baptized at St. Bernard's Church in Saranac Lake. Moved to Rochester in 1959, and she made her journey of faith. She came right to Holy Cross when she got to Rochester, so she's been here a good number of years. She went through trying times. Seven children were raised in the Catholic faith, even though she went through some painful divorces, so forth. The children still were educated at Corpus Christi School and Bishop Kearney High School. Imagine, some people will say, well, will I send my child to a Catholic? No, it doesn't work that way. So on and on it goes about how wonderful she was, and she is wonderful, and knowing her humility, you can say this stuff without thinking that if she were here, she'd get all puffed up. No, she wouldn't. She was a Eucharistic minister here. She was absolutely loved. She absolutely loved helping. it turns out to be my own name here, because I do the I do the mass over at Shorewinds. But she loved to be so much a part of that. And the nursing home scene, as we all know, is very challenging at times and so forth. She, until her very last breath, Bernie was continually saying to Mary. She kept telling her children that the Lord and she had an issue to work out. That is why she was still here. That was why she was still here, because they had that issue to work out. So, all in all, we have somebody here who is absolutely, during her own life, was a role model for everybody who knew her, and those who knew her obviously loved her. So, I often use this phrase about imagining somebody like Bernie arriving into the glory of heaven, about which St. Paul says, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has it so much as entered into our hearts to know what God has prepared for those who love him. Please stand for our general intercessions. God the Father in heaven loved Bernie as did His Son, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, as did Our Lady and all the saints. Help us now to keep her before us as a wonderful role model as we now make our intentions to God the Father.
Our sister Bernadette was nourished at the table of the Lord. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who loved and were loved by Bernie, that we may find comfort in our belief in the Lord's promise to us of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us with whom Bernie so generously shared her many gifts, may we too grow in the ability to share our gifts and lighten the burdens of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died in the hope of rising again, especially Bernie, her daughter Cynthia, her son Jerry, her parents, John and Lillian, and her three brothers. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of Bernie's family, her son Raymond and Kathy, her daughters Patricia and Robert, Melinda, Kathleen, and Colleen, her daughter-in-law Patricia, her 9 grandchildren and her 7 great-grandchildren, her sisters Maureen and Gary, and Dolores, her sisters-in-law, Mary and Kathleen, her nieces and nephews, and for all of her family and friends, that they will know the peace of the Lord in this time of sadness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for each of us here present, that God will bless us richly with the gifts he knows we need to fully celebrate life and recognize the new beginning which he offers us each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father of us all, we come before you, sad, but internally extremely joyful because of the fact that Bernie is with you, and that one day, with your continued help, we may be with her, and through her and all the saints, we will be with you. Help us in this remaining journey that we have through Christ our Lord.
Please be seated. The gifts of bread and wine to be used at this Mass will be brought forward by Bernie's sister and brother-in-law, Maureen and Gary, and her daughters, Melinda and Colleen. As the gifts are being brought forward, please join in the offertory hymn number 680, Be Not Afraid, found in the red hymnals in the pews.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Bernie, we beg your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your heart.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord. It is, for it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin, so that earth from which, to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end. we acclaim. For the Eucharistic prayer, please either kneel or be seated according to your custom. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, for the forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you.
Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Bernadette, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with you in baptism, may now come to the fullness of the resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse, Saint Joseph, with the holy apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. As we prepare now for communion, we remind folks that all those who plan to receive and are prepared to receive, please come up to the center aisle and return by way of the side aisle. For those who want to partake of the Eucharist under both forms of the consecrated bread and wine, cup ministers of the precious blood are here. For those not receiving, we encourage you to simply remain with us in a spirit of love and prayer today.
At this time, we invite Bernie's son Raymond to offer some words of remembrance.
Family, for one, to show that there are men in the family. As most of you know, we're fairly dominated by women. And like mom, fairly strong-minded women at that. Bernadette, Bernie, mom, Grandma, Gigi. She wore many different titles, every one of them with pride. Raising seven children was not easy, especially back in the day when having one with special needs was not looked upon too well. Suggestions of putting my sister Cindy in a home, needless to say, did not sit well with my mom. She would not have anything like that whatsoever. She worked hard to raise seven of us, working many jobs, in most cases two at a time, sometimes three. Mostly at night, make sure that one parent was home at all times. Always making sure we had a meal on the stove before she left. As many of you know, my mom was very quiet. Kept her opinions to herself. It was hard to understand where she stood. I told you, even in church, it wouldn't go over well. She, without a doubt, was a very strong-minded woman, and it's reflected throughout her whole family, and her daughters, her daughter-in-laws, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren. Even with seven kids, she enjoyed life to the fullest. Always doing everything she could to try to take those summer trips, either to Canada or the many camping trips to Letchworth, Wellesley Island. Seven kids, two parents in a 12-man tent. Needless to say, you could write many of your own stories on that. One of our favorite pastimes with Mom was as she prepared for work each evening and settled in for her TV watching time and having one of the old style hair dryers where you put the cap on your head, you had the hose, and then she would proceed to watch her favorite soap operas while she went to sleep. And we took great joy in trying to decipher the little mumbles that she would talk to herself. I think for the most part it was Miss Chancellor on The Young and the Restless wasn't a very nice lady, I don't think. Mom never lost her faith in God, but there, unfortunately, was a period of time where Mom did not feel comfortable in church, particularly the parish at that time that we belonged to. I know for years that weighed on her heavily. And then she had the opportunity to come back here to Holy Cross, met Father Reif, who without a doubt we've come to meet and know fairly well over the last several months. And it became very quickly obvious why she thought so highly of him and why she felt so happy to be back here. She felt included again. In a time like this, that means more to me and my family than anything. Over the last several years, the last couple of decades, my brother, my sisters, and I were privileged to be able to help assist my mom in achieving some of her worldly goals of traveling. She was able to accomplish quite a bit. Several trips to Florida with the grandkids. Hawaii, without a doubt, one of her favorite. And then fairly recently, a religious retreat through Europe, which I know meant the world to her. But we will always remember all the many things that Mom provided to us. To set a meal. And always teaching us. Yeah, sometimes being a part of a family ain't easy. When you have seven children, they're not always going to be quite on the same page. But even in the bad times, I know she took very much pride in all of us. Some of you may not know, Mom was never much of a animal lover, which is why many people are always puzzled why we always had a cat and a dog. And as most of us kids moved out of the house, she was left a companion for my sister Colleen as she moved to Boston. And a very feisty cat named Milton that Mom still took a lot of pride in taking care of and watching over. My family's had a tough couple months, to say the least. My brother passing unexpectedly a couple months ago. Needless to say, took its toll on Mom. It is not the way it's supposed to be. But I think my family and I took comfort over the last couple of months, last several weeks rather, even though it was difficult watching Ma have a roller coaster ride for several weeks in the hospital, real bad days, we were blessed to have several good days. Days where we were able to talk with her and laugh with her again. And I thank the Lord for those days. In hindsight, I think it was her way of helping to make everything easier in the end. Now she is where she wants to be. Back with her daughter, her son, her brothers, her parents. Without a doubt, family meant the world to Mom. And although, thankfully, my kids are not of the age to have their own kids yet and appreciate the struggles and hassles of being a parent, I have been blessed on several occasions from each of my children. To tell me what they think, that they think what a good dad I am. And I immediately know that I owe all of that to her. It is to say, she will never be forgotten. And I know there's many things that I came up here to say that I will forget. And I apologize for that. But who knew there were so many things to do in putting a funeral together. And even some guidelines, such as a eulogy should be roughly 3 to 5 minutes. But I think Father, knowing my mom fairly well, knew that that wasn't going to happen. In closing, in times like this, you hear things from many friends, family members you haven't seen in many years, certainly not seen enough. And it's unfortunate that moments like this are when it happens. We get to see each other again, talk again. But at least it happens. And such, I've had some good friends share some things with me in the past several weeks. To me, quite a bit. Your mom is always with you. She's the whisper of the leaves as you walk down the street. She's the smell of certain foods you remember. Flowers you pick, the fragrance of life itself. She's the cool hand on your brow when you're not feeling well. She's your breath in the air on a cold winter's day. She's the sound of the rain that lulls you to sleep. The color of a rainbow. She is Christmas morning. Your mother lives inside your laughter. She's the place you came from, your first home. She's the map you follow with every step you take. She's your first love, your first friend, even your first enemy. But nothing on earth can separate you, not time, not space, not even death. Thank you, Mom, for all that you have done for us.
And thanks to you, Ray, for those very, very heartfelt words of remembrance. And as we remember and prepare to leave now, we have our final blessings and the incensing. And if you would please stand. Thanks. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Bernadette, Bernie, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.
walk